Hello, it's Richard Bowser here from Property Investor News, and I've come across Dan Nelson from propertyCEO.
Good to see you, Richard. How are you?
Good to see you, mate. Yeah, lovely. Really busy show. We're here at the Landlord Investment Show at Billingsgate, and just talking with Dan about the way the market's evolving. As readers of Property Investor News will know, Richard Clapton is a regular contributor to Property Investor News, talking about planning and in particular talking about property development for the small scale property developer. So Dan, you know, how are you guys seeing the market at the moment in what has obviously been the last 12 months? We've had a big turnaround in the lending sort of landscape, but how are you seeing things?
Yeah, I mean, it's a great question. I mean, the landscape's changed massively in this sector. We're seeing a lot of buy-to-let landlords now transitioning into small-scale development.
Yes.
They're not getting the returns they once had.
Yep.
You know, we've been squeezed by interest rate hikes,
yes,
which has been, you know, an absolute, you know, nightmare for most landlords.
Yeah.
And it's forced a lot of landlords to sell.
Yes.
I think with propertyCEO and more so with small-scale development, with the permitted development rights that are now in place, you know, and the government's drive to repurpose these brownfield sites,
yes,
you know, your shops, your banks, your light industrial units,
yep,
your gyms,
yep,
into residential is a key time.
Absolutely.
You know, it's a critical time.
Yeah, I mean, we literally did a webinar a couple of nights ago. A couple of hundred people attended, all
wow,
about the changes to permitted development as a result of this recent consultation period. So,
absolutely,
you know, which may, and it obviously, is that the likelihood is that early next year, some of those rights will change, and there are going to be more opportunities.
Well, we were hoping for them to come in this year. There's,
yep,
still a chance they could,
right,
in November,
yes,
possibly,
yep,
December. But they're big changes.
Yes.
They're big changes that are coming in. But in 2020, you know, PD rights were kind of updated.
They were.
2021, they were revised to create super class E.
Yes.
Which groups a lot of these commercial buildings into one use class.
Yep.
Now, by using class MA, you can convert them into C3, which is residential.
Yes.
Interesting stat here, just for the viewers.
Absolutely.
The CPRE. I've basically predicted, their statistics show that 1.2 million new homes can be introduced into the market just by repurposing these brownfield sites. That's 1.2 million homes.
Yeah, yeah.
And what we've got, a target of 300,000 homes a year.
Yeah.
It was a target that was
4 years supply.
100%.
Yeah.
And you know, 2017, the 300,000 a year target was brought in by Phil Hammond.
Yeah.
It was reintroduced again by Michael Gove in 2019. We've never hit those numbers.
No.
You know, we don't build anywhere near enough homes. It's about 150,000 homes a year that we build. So if you think about the deficit, Richard, over those years, it's more like 1 million homes that we need. And brownfield empty buildings as it stands right now can generate around 1.2 million homes into the market, which is why there's a big push.
Yeah. So obviously brownfield rather than green belt, there is a massive resistance to green belt encroachment, rightly or wrongly, you know, but as I always say to people, swim with the tide rather than against it.
Absolutely.
And without question, you know, although there is some opposition towards some aspects of permitted development, you know, in some councils, and I get it, I mean, I understand why, but you know, there's no question that from an investment point of view, brownfield conversions, particularly commercial properties, I mean, clearly, you know, the last 3 years, the results of COVID,
yeah,
impacting on so many aspects of the commercial property sector,
yeah,
the retail landscape is transformed. Offices obviously undergoing a huge
100%
sea change.
The offices are closing down, scaling,
yeah,
down. People are working in different ways.
Yes.
And I think a lot of businesses now have kind of adopted the hybrid work from,
yes,
home model.
Yeah.
People are quite happy to move out a little bit further.
Yeah.
They've got a longer commute.
Yes.
They're getting a bigger bang for their buck. They've only got to spend one or two days in the office.
Yeah. Yeah.
Industrial scaling down. People are working in different ways. Retail.
Yes.
Gyms, banks, crèches. Yeah. The list goes on.
No, it does. And of course, it's about being ahead of the curve, isn't it?
Absolutely. Yeah, it is.
We, you and I, CEO Richie, we can
and
see
probably
what's
most
happening.
Of your listeners as well.
Yeah,
you know, they're all educated people.
Yes,
but, you know, they'll watch your videos and follow.
Yeah,
and they'll know that permitted development rights is creating an incredible opportunity, not just for us as investors and developers, but also for people that are looking for homes, and also business owners that have been left holding the baby, for the want of a better expression.
Yeah.
Because if you've got an empty commercial building, all of the business rates go back up to the landlord. And if they're looking to sell to a commercial tenant, you know, and the building's empty,
yeah,
the longer that building's empty, the less value it
indeed,
is.
Yes.
So they're looking for another exit, and PD provides that plan B for them. It provides a secondary exit. They may not have had it before it existed.
Yeah.
So it's a bit of a win-win.
Yeah, absolutely. Right. But as with all of these things, as I keep saying, the devil's in the detail.
Absolutely.
Some of this stuff is not simple. You do need to understand the nuances. And of course, that's where Property CEO comes in, doesn't
absolutely,
it?
Absolutely, yeah.
Let's just summarise by very briefly explaining what Property CEO does as a business.
Yeah, Bruce, you're absolutely right. This is not easy. This is hard work, but it's entirely possible. And at Property CEO, this is all about mitigating risk. We train buy-to-let landlords, investors, landlords that have got HMOs, people even from a standing start that want to change their lives. Get into small-scale development, utilising PD, is mitigating most of that risk, and it's giving you the ability to look at diversifying and doing something else within your business. But least barriers to entry. And that's where PD comes in.
Yeah.
And that's what we specialize in here at Property CEO. It's actually training people how to get into development property. It's taking, probably one of the most professionally qualified property development trainers, probably the only professionally qualified property development trainers. He's been in the industry for 45 years, worked on some of the most iconic projects, the National Aquatic Center, the Velodrome, Goodwood Festival of Speed, Wimbledon Center Court retracting roof, built out hundreds of thousands of homes across England. And a Property CEO, that's what we specialise in. You know, working with developers just like you that want to transition and do it properly. That's
there
what we
go.
Do.
So the website URL?
www.propertyceo.co.uk.
There you are.